So what's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to the show Programming Users TV. In this class I'm going to provide you guys with a detailed introduction to Flask. Okay, so we're going to see Flask, we're going to introduce it in less than 10 minutes. So what is Flask? Well, Flask is a micro framework that allows to develop web applications, and of course we use the Python programming language. It is a Python framework. Now Flask was actually created in the year 2010 by Amin Ronacha and is actually released under the BSD license. So it's actually based on Wasuj and Jinja 2, and of course Wasuj actually is a toolkit that is the toolkit that allows Flask to listen to as well as answer to requests. So Jinja 2 on the other hand is just a templating language and allow us to pass data to our HTML user interface and also perform basic expressions, okay, using Python. So most frameworks normally, as you know, majority of the web frameworks normally do implement the MVC, the model view controller paradigm. However, Flask as a micro framework only implements the V and C, that is the view and the controller, but not the model. Okay, so it's intentionally leaving out the M or the model since it's a micro framework and actually aims to be thin and lean. So the model is normally the data layer, and Flask actually is leaving you to choose a wealth of third-party extensions for yourself that you can actually use with your data. So Flask, of course, its aim is actually to be as small and thin as possible, so its feature set has actually been limited. Okay, now this of course is intentional, and this actually makes Flask more unopinionated so that it can cater for a wide variety of developers. So for instance, with Flask you can actually write a simple but a fully working and deployable web app in just a single file. So normally majority of web frameworks you actually can't do that. You normally have to write make a couple of configurations and installations just to have your web app running. Now with Flask, once you've installed Flask, and it's actually very simple, you just do that one with a single command, you can write to a full web application in just a single file. So let's look at some of the fundamental features that Flask provides. First and foremost, of course, we've said Flask is actually a framework, a web framework, and because it is a web framework, it provides a set of libraries that will give the generic solutions via their various abstractions so as to ease our work as developers. Now some of these features or generic solutions that Flask provides include, first, the development server as well as the debugger. Then Flask actually comes with its own server, okay, a simple server that you can use for development, and this is a debugger to help you identify bugs in your program. Then there's also the URL routing, which is probably fundamental to web frameworks. There's also the templating, okay, templating engine through the Jinja 2. Okay, Jinja 2 is actually a templating engine. Then there's also the sessions. Okay, Flask allows us to handle and manage sessions as well as cookies. Okay, there's also the request handling, given that it does it's actually WSGI, it has a server that is WSGI enabled. So there's also the Unicode support in Flask. So these are just some, and already these are just some of those features that Flask does provide us. Okay, and these features that we've already provide us with powerful capabilities that can allow us to make our web applications. For example, we can actually handle the browser requests, we can route HTTP requests to controllers, we can also manage sessions, we can handle AJAX requests, and we can even evaluate form data, so, and return our data in form of HTML or JSON. Now let's look also at the features that Flask leaves out. Okay, we said already that as a micro framework, Flask intentionally leaves out some features. Okay, so it does not come bundled with all functionalities like other frameworks like Django. So Some of these features that Flask leaves out include the database integration, okay, so the forms library also, and the administration user interface, administration interface, okay. So, but on the other hand, it's also important to emphasize that each of these features and the other features can actually be installed from third party, okay. They can be installed as third party libraries just via single three word command. So we said Flask is actually based on Wsuge and Jinja 2. So let's introduce these two. So what is Wsuge? Well, it's actually a utility library for WSGI. WSGI stands for the Web Server Gateway Interface, and it's a protocol that ensures the following. First, it ensures that a web application or the web application that you write can actually communicate effectively with the web server, okay? If you're writing your web application, it's actually going to be hosted on the server, so your web app needs a reliable way of being able to communicate with the web server. That is the first. And secondly, it also ensures that the web applications that you write can actually place nicely or work nicely with other web applications, okay? So probably your server is going to host multiple web apps, not just yours. So WSGI, of course, a web server that is WSGI is going to ensure that first, as you said, your web can communicate effectively with the server, and secondly, that all those web apps can actually play nicely together, okay? They can work nicely together with each other. So in short, WSGI is just a Python interface between our web applications as well as the variety of servers that we use for both development as well as deployment. So if you want to know more about, of course, WSGI, if you want to know more about the Wsuge, you can actually find more information in this particular URL right here, okay? So we're going to leave it with this particular article which we're going to post in our site. So what is Jinja 2? Well, Jinja 2 also is actually the second major feature or toolkit that Flask comes bundled with, okay? So Jinja 2 is just a modern templating language for Python, okay? It's a templating language, and it was influenced by Django's template. So as a templating language, of course, Jinja 2 is built to be fast and secure, and it also provides a sandboxed template execution environment. So for a templating, normally we use templating languages to pass our variables from our Python to our user interface, okay? So for example, if you're writing your web application, you're going to write it in Python, all right? However, you'll want to show the results in the HTML, pass it in the user interface to the HTML so that it can be rendered. So of course, one way is that you can just mix your HTML and Python, but of course, as you know, that's not a very appropriate way of doing it. Or the other way, which is better, is to use a templating language like Jinja 2. Therefore, you just separate your view from the model. So the view is the user interface, and view from the controller, okay? Well, the controller is the Python code that you're going to write in Flask. So, of course, yeah, you can also find more information about Jinja 2 in this particular link that you're going to leave. So let's now come talk about installation of Flask. Okay, so Flask, as you said, is a Python framework. So first, we have to ensure that you have Python installed. So Flask requires Python 2.6 or newer. And first, you actually need the virtual env. Okay, now by then, I think I'm just reaching 10 minutes, so I'm going to leave installation for the next tutorial. So we've introduced Flask in this particular class. I want this tutorial to be short, so if you want to install Flask, please follow the next tutorial. We're going to see how to install Flask in that particular tutorial. So for now, like this video, share it, and make sure you guys subscribe to our channel, Programming Users TV. We're going to leave this documentation in our website, so you guys can follow it up, okay? Otherwise, take care. I'll catch you in the next class.